Green care is a relatively new concept that deals with the interface of societies and nature. In this interface, especially the health aspects are the most important topic that green care deals with. My name is Peter Meyer. I'm the managing director of the Austrian Research Center for Forests. With green care, we work on a new dimension, which can be related to the social dimension of sustainability. As a citizen, green care means recreation in forests and landscapes. We all need these landscapes and natural environment after stressful work days. Our societies, especially our Western societies, suffer from dense workloads, from poor health, and landscapes and forests provide an excellent opportunity for recreation. Green care is a concept that is very challenging, but also very important for the future. Next 3 days, there's an international conference that deals with landscapes and human health. There are 27 countries that are represented in this conference, more than 130 participants. So it will be a very lively conference where there's a lot of opportunity to learn from each other and to exchange views.
Where we are very keen on also receiving your expertise during the conference, but also for making new friends during these 3 days.
I'm Carolina from Taiwan, and I represent the International Forestry Students Association. And I would love to learn about the positive relationship and the possibilities between forests and human health.
I have a lot of expectations about this conference.
We are very looking forward to this discuss the topic.
Because I'm interested in the environmental determinants of health.
Nature and well-being and the interaction.
Interesting other research.
More of a broad understanding of how landscape and urban planning fits into the things that we do with psychology.
There is a need of practical input.
I expect from the conference that we are going to be able to meet each other and share our ideas.
Vienna is a capital with a green heart beating for natural and urban landscapes.
Green care in Vienna is a very important task, and it has a very long history. It dates back to the beginning of the 20th century, and the Viennese are very aware of the quality of life they have in their city. I consider the quality of life in Vienna really excellent. So they provide not only beautiful forests, but also the preconditions for health and well-being. That means really clear drinking water, and you have the recreation area in a very close distance. The first foundation for this excellent quality dates back to the beginning of the 19th century when the Municipal Council of Vienna in 1905 declared the Green Belt around Vienna.
Science delivers the basis for creativity and new ideas.
There are more than 60 oral presentations that you're going to be able to listen to over the next 1.5 days, covering a very diverse range of topics, a very diverse range of landscapes, landscape types, and also addressing various target audiences. We also have 25 posters, which you are able to view outside in the foyer.
We have meanwhile established a relationship that green areas are positive on humans. So there are many open questions regarding what effects different kinds of green have. Is a forest better than a meadow? Is a more natural forest better than a less natural forest? International research is dealing with many different aspects. So what we can see is, of course, a deeper evaluation of the effects of different kinds of green and gray spaces or blue spaces. We also see that research is now focusing on specific groups, how we can encourage these people to go to green spaces. In Austria, we have a huge green capital. We have forests, we have protected areas, and all these provide a high quality of nature. And the question is, how can we use this quality of nature for human health and well-being?
I guess the thing that really interests me most, coming from the medical background, is to say, how can we quantify all the amazing benefits we've seen in a way that's going to appeal to medics, to GPs, to public commissioners, and ultimately to government bodies?
International discussions and networking provide impulses for local initiatives.
Local initiatives, in my view, are the most important building blocks for building nature-based green welfare. Nevertheless, they need to be supported by the best possible scientific evidence, scientific information, but also by effective policy and governance frameworks in order to be able to succeed. From a more international perspective, the most significant development is the adoption of the so-called Sustainable Development Goals by the United Nations in September 2015. One of those so-called SDGs specifically addresses human health and well-being. Another of those goals addresses forests and nature. And our task is to build the connection between these two in order to really make sure that from a global perspective, we can see even more progress in improving well-being and health of people worldwide. A leading role in research on human health and development can be assigned to Asian countries. Countries like Japan and Korea have been working on this issue for a long time.
I think the currently our society has many kind of the problem, the social problem and the environmental problem. But I think is the forest is a key solution to solve this problem.
The field of research, I would say, is immense. Think about major global challenges such as globalization, urbanization, automatization, digitalization. All this will have a profound impact on how we use and perceive forests. As became evident also during the past 1.5 days here at this conference, this is a vast field addressing the various dimensions of the subject. The one thing that is probably missing is the level of political recognition which these issues would deserve.
Let me now give the floor to the Director General of Austria, Mr. Gerhard Mansberger.
My name is Gerhard Mansberger. I am Director General of the Forestry Department in the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry, Water Management and Environment. Looking at all the activities concerning green care issues, it will be more and more important. Important for the society, for the demands of society, but also important for the forest owners as an additional income source.
The conference will raise politicians' awareness for green care issues.
My name is Ludmila Marušaková, I'm from Slovakia and I'm representing Forest Europe, which is a high-level political platform for cooperation on sustainable forest management in Europe. Social aspects and social pillars of sustainability received great attention in recent years.
The scientific community contributes to closing the gap between theory and practical implementation.
Practical implementation of the green care and also of the conference is that it could serve as a best practice example for other countries how to generate new green jobs and using positive benefits of forests and impacts of forests on human health and well-being. The outcomes of this project could be very beneficial for the implementation of Forest Europe work program because it could contribute significantly to gathering new knowledge in this field and for the formulation of the practical recommendations and recommendations for policymakers that could strengthen the social aspect of sustainable forest management. It could be a new chance for forest sector to strengthen social aspects of sustainable forest management.
I'm Georg Wiesinger. I'm working at the Austrian Federal Institute for Less Favored and Mountainous Areas here in Vienna. The practitioners need schemes, they need concepts, how to implement the enterprises. And we as researchers, we have to give strong evidence that these schemes are really important for society and that they should be supported by the public and the authorities. I think there's a huge demand in society And as you know, green care practice is always connected with social practice. You can't separate green exercise and the social field, and you have to connect them.
I'm Nicole Propp. I'm the managing director of the association Green Care Austria. I'm working for a green care project in the agricultural area, and I'm Dutch, living in Austria. And the largest deficiency is the fact that in Austria you have a lot of different stakeholders from the educational, social, health, agricultural area. They all speak their own language, and the difficulty is that in Austria you have 9 different federal states, and each federal state has their own laws. So that's sometimes quite difficult to put them together and make one project out of it. But it's going on in Austria. And the practical part of this issue is our project, which we actually started 2011, that people who finished in education can also find a job in the green care area. So I think it's very important.
The conference will be rounded off by 2 excursions here in Vienna, which will allow you to get a very direct and empirical, so to say, insight into the local cultural and national landscapes of Vienna.
The Wienerwald we will visit today is a UNESCO Biosphere Reserve. It is located in Vienna and in Lower Austria, and it is characterized by a mix of meadows, of different forest types, of settlements, of vineyards. It's a very diverse landscape. There are more than 30 forest types in the Biosphere Reserve. There are more than 23 meadow types and over 2,000 plant species. And nearly 1 million people live in the Biosphere District. And the Wienerwald provides a lot of health benefits for the local residents, especially for the urban population of Vienna and for tourists.
Up is from Vienna, up is from Low Austria.
It became evident that this research field develops very, very fast, immensely fast, also from the presentations over the past few days. We heard that, you know, a lot of methods and theories have been developed, and now this research field is also moving into a more consolidated way of synthesizing existing scientific information, drawing, you know, more coherent conclusions from scientific assessments and so on. So a very rapid development. Nevertheless, given the global challenges that we are facing, this is also needed, and this is more than appropriate.
We think that we played kind of an important role, and we are also willing to play this role in the future.
With the demands of nowadays life, the connection to nature gets more and more important and can help people to stay healthy or get healthy.
So Green Care and also this conference gather a lot of very important expertise and a lot of outputs of the research, which is very significant for all who work in forest sector.
Green Care is a very good incentive for improving, facilitating life and improving the quality of life of people.
It generates a lot of possibilities for the forest sector to create new green jobs using these positive benefits and impacts of forests on human health.
What I would take home is more inspiration and the confidence that we are going to build a better world.
So I have a very new idea.
The meeting of the different disciplines.
The waterfalls in Austria and just how powerful they are for potential for health gains.
A lot of positive energy for myself because I would like to start projects.
New expertise, new impressions.
A very good starting point for new projects.
I got a lot of hope.